Death in Harry Potter is the most tragic scenes, but considering that some death scenes are kept out of the movies and not everyone have read the books, I'm going to explain in this video how did some Harry Potter characters die. Remus and Tonks. During the Battle of Hogwarts, Remus and Tonks answered Neville Longbottom's call to fight. Tonks initially agreed not to participate in the Battle of Hogwarts and stayed staying with her son, but was ultimately unable to see her husband leaving to face such danger without her. She left Tiddy with her mother and went to Hogwarts. Remus was last seen dueling Death Eater Antonio Dolohov. After a couple minutes, Dolohov murdered Remus, who was no longer in prime fighting condition due to months of protective and concealment charms in order to keep his wife and son safe from possible attacks. He was murdered in the main courtyard during the first half of the battle, along with many others. Lupin's death was avenged by Filius Flitwick, who defeated and murdered Dolohov. Tonks, however, was killed by her own aunt, Bellatrix, probably because she had just recovered from childbirth. Her death, however, was avenged by Molly, when she in return killed Bellatrix. Harry had a clear view of the bodies lying next to Fred, Remus and Tonks, pale and still, and peaceful looking. Fred Weasley. His death was also during the Battle of Hogwarts. He and George were assigned to defend the castle's secret passages. They were along with Percy, whom he was fighting with his minister, transformed him, and made a joke about him. "You're joking, Percy? You actually are joking, Percy? I don't think I've heard you joke since you were..." The air exploded. They had been grouped together. "No! No! Fred, no!" He was dead. Fred was killed in an explosion outside the Room of Requirements. One of the last things Fred heard before dying was Percy joking about resigning for the ministry. Percy wouldn't leave Fred's side until Harry helped him move the body to somewhere safer. His body was later moved to the Great Hall, where family and friends were devastated by his death. Peter Pettigrew. His death was at Malfoy Manor. Harry, Ron and the others were imprisoned in the basement. When Peter went downstairs and opened the door, he was tackled by Ron and Harry, who had freed themselves of their restraint. Ron managed to take Pettigrew's wand from him. He began to strangle Harry, but Harry reminded him that he owed him a life debt. Voldemort cursed the hand that he gave him back then, and when Pettigrew hesitated and showed Harry mercy by letting him escape, the hand turned on him and proceeded to choke him to death. Regardless of Harry and Ron's best efforts to restrain it, Harry, while disliking Pettigrew of his cowardice and betrayal, nevertheless felt some pity for the way he had to die, and was perhaps one of the few to accept of Pettigrew's regret of his life choices. Ariana Dumbledore. She was Albus Dumbledore's only sister. At some point, Gilead Grindelwald came to Godric's Hollow to stay with his great aunt, Bathilda Bagshot. After having been kicked out of Durmstrang Institute, Albus and Gilead quickly became friends, as they were both extremely talented and very ambitious. The two formed a plan to take over the wizarding world and make Muggles subservient. Albus' brother Aberforth disagreed over these plans, pointing out that Ariana was in no state to be dragged along with them as they achieved their goals. Grindelwald became furious, then a three-wheel duel broke out between him, Albus, and Aberforth. Ariana, aged about 14 at the time and unable to control her magic, tried to stop them and was accidentally killed. It was never known which of the three wizards were directly responsible for her death. Aberforth never forgave his brother for his part in her death, nor was Albus ever able to forgive himself. Gilead Grindelwald. After Grindelwald was defeated by Dumbledore, he brought him to the authorities of the magical world, resulting in Grindelwald being imprisoned in the cell of Nurmengard Prison. In 1998, 53 years after his defeat, Grindelwald woke up to find Lord Voldemort in his prison cell, who was searching for the Elder Wand for himself. The Dark Lord expected fear and surprise, but was himself surprised to find Grindelwald, who was not only unafraid, but had been also expecting his visit for some time. Despite being unarmed and defenseless against the most powerful dark wizard to have ever existed, Grindelwald refused to give up the location of the Elder Wand, while calling Voldemort by his name. flame and laughing at his desire for the wind, having decided to protect the Elder One from Voldemort in order to try to achieve a level of redemption, thus Voldemort ended Grindelwald's life with the Killing Curse. It was believed that Grindelwald had given his life to prevent Voldemort from discreting Dumbledore's grave, perhaps indicating that despite all that happened, Grindelwald still kept some care and respect for his old friend Dumbledore. Mad-Eye Moody. During the flight of Seven Potters, Moody and Fletcher were heading north. Voldemort showed up using his ability to fly. He went straight for them as he believed Harry would be flying with the most skilled witch or wizard in the guard, which was Alastair Moody. Fletcher panicked, crying out, and Moody tried to stop him, but Mandarkins disappeared, leaving Moody vulnerable to attack. Voldemort fired a killing curse the second that Mandarkins disappeared and hit Moody in the face. Moody fell backwards off his broom and down to the ground. Moody fell about 1000 feet with no wind, making his death a certainty. Bill and Lupin volunteered to search for Moody's body to give him a proper burial, but they could find no trace of it. However, after Harry took Moody's eye from Umbridge's office, he later searched the woods for the oldest, most gnarled looking tree he could find. Then in its shadow, he buried the eye. While it was in March, Mad-Eye Moody was given a proper burial as far as was possible. Helena Ravenclaw. She was the daughter of Rowena Ravenclaw. Helena was always in her mother's shadow and jealous of her cleverness and importance. While Helena was still at the school, she stole her mother's diadem from jealousy and ran away, leaving Scotland forever and believing the item could help her become wise enough to surpass her mother. Rowena was so ashamed of her daughter's betrayal and never admitted the story, hiding the fact that the diadem was no longer in her possession. When Rowena was on her deathbed, she asked the Baron, aka Slytherin's ghost, who was deeply in love with Helena, to find her daughter and bring her back to her so that she could see her one last time. Helena tried to hide from him, but the Baron managed to track her down to a forest in Albania. When she heard the Baron coming through the forest toward her, she hid the diadem inside a tree. Helena refused to come with the Baron and rejected his affections again. Being furious at her refusal and jealous of her freedom, he stabbed her in a fit of rage with a knife. After seeing what he had done, regretting his action, he stabbed himself to death and the two died together. Helena returned from the dead as a ghost and gained the name the Grey Lady, where she became the house ghost of her former house, Ravenclaw.